Hello all, I'm Ketan, trainer for Android application development with Naresh AI Technologies. In this session, we'll be looking at the Google Play Store, which will provide the option to market your application. You'll be having an idea to develop an application. You'll be converting an idea into the application. And one side is developing the application, what you love the most. And the other one is you should know how to market your application. So to market your application, you'll be having the Google Play Store, which is the premium app store for distributing your Android applications. You can access this app store from this link over here, play.google.com, and straight away the home page will give you different categories. You'll be having different application categories here. Other side, you'll be having games, and you'll be having the family related applications. So you have to place your application on this Google Play Store so that it will be distributed across n number of countries. And this app store will be having global reach. It means it will be available across many countries and territories. Once you place your application and once you make the application compatible with multiple languages, you can distribute your application across almost 190 countries and different territories. And on the Play Store, you are having almost 1 billion active users. So your targeting users will be more in number when you place your application on the Google Play Store. So let us have a look at what this Play Store is going to provide and how you will be placing the application on the Play Store. And after placing the application on the Play Store, how you should optimize your application. So the first part is the searching part. If you go to this page here, top, you'll be typing some keyword. Based on the keyword what you're keying in here, you'll be getting the search results. When you search for some Twitter application, you'll be getting the results for the Twitter application. And this list will be showing you all the results here. And this is the search results page. So you can straight away enter the keyword into the Play Store and it will automatically do the search and it will give you the search results. The next part is browsing part. When you browse for any application on the Play Store, straight away it will display a page. When you open this Twitter application, so this will display the details about this Twitter application. When you see on the top left, you are having the high resolution icon. Then you have title for the application. Below to that, you'll be having the company name. To the right side of the company name, you have the application category and the ratings for the application. And it will display the compatibilities. When you are developing an application, you can develop the application targeting n number of devices. And you have different categories like smartphones, tablet PCs, then you have Android TVs. So it will display what type of device your application is compatible with, and it will display the status here itself. And below to that, you are having some screenshots as well as a video here. And below to that, you have the short description. And when you click on this, it will give you the full description about the application. So when you browse for the application, it will display all the details about the application, like your application title, then the description, then you'll be having some screencasts. All these things you can browse. And after that, once you like the application, you can download the APK file. You can install the application either from your browser or from the device. So when you log in into your Gmail account from the browser, your Gmail account will be synchronized with your device. So directly the installation option will make your application download directly on the device. So you can have your application on the device itself from the browser. And as you keep on using the application, you'll be finding some good things and bad things in the application. Based on that, you'll be giving a review for the application, and the users can feed in their opinions about the application. So these opinions, these reviews will matter the most to the application developer. As an application developer, one should continuously review the comments, you should observe the ratings, and accordingly, you should correct the things in the application. So four basic things: the searching part, the browsing part, looking into the details, downloading and installing the application. After that, writing reviews and giving ratings for the application. And when you take the opportunities, what this Google Play Store will be providing, first one is the intelligent discovery option. So the Play Store will be having many algorithms that will be running internally. Once you type some keyword, it will bring you all the applications on the front page depending on the keyword what you have given. So depending on the keyword, all the relevant applications will be displayed, and you'll be having different segments, like you'll be having top charts, then you'll be having new releases. Everything will be filtered according to the algorithms and according to the ratings and reviews for the application. So if the ratings are poor and reviews are bad, the position of your application will go down on the Play Store. The second part is developer page. You can create a page for your application for promoting. You can promote your brand here by creating the developer page. You can add your company logo or your own personalized image. You can have a logo, and then you can write the description, and you can provide a link to your website and your application as well. So this becomes the greatest way to promote your application as well as your brand. So on your brand, you'll be developing multiple applications. You can promote all your applications once you have the brand page, the developer page. And the next one is the Google Play Store listing page. So users can see the ratings and reviews. If you place your application on the Play Store, once it is downloaded by n number of people, they'll be providing the ratings and reviews. You can have the developer console, and you can continuously see the ratings and reviews. And the other part is editor's choice. To the left side here, you'll be having the editor's choice. When you click on this, this will give you the list of applications that will be picked by the editorial team. Google will be having an internal editorial team that will be continuously filtering the applications. They'll be checking the applications for quality, performance, and how the application is running on the device, how many devices the application is compatible with. Based on a specific set of criteria, applications will be picked up by the editors, and all these applications will fall under this editor's choice. So these are the different opportunities the Play Store will be providing, and the Google Play Store listing page. So when you publish any application on the Play Store, you need to provide some content that belongs to your application. So that content includes some sort of short description, a full description where the users can go into the inner levels of depth, and you'll be providing some graphic assets to showcase your application or brand, and you'll be asked to select the category of the application and type of the application, and as well you'll be providing all your contact details. So to publish applications onto the Play Store, you require a Google Publisher account. So you can access the publisher account by using this link over here. Once you access this, it will ask you for your Gmail credentials. You can sign in with your Gmail username and password. And two types here. One thing is the account which is not having the developer license. So this is the account that is not having the developer license here. So this kind of dashboard will be displayed. And the first step is sign in with your Google account. This is already signed in. The next part is accepting the developer agreement. You'll be having a Google Play developer distribution agreement that will give you the guidelines about how to develop the applications and what are the procedures you need to follow, what are the laws you need to abide with, and what are the different policies you should not overrule while you are developing the application. So this will define the terms in terms of pricing and payments. Then you have to support your product once it is placed on the Play Store, and you'll be given the authority to refund. If it is a paid application, the user can pay the amount and then he can install the application. If he don't like the application, he can ask for a refund, and then you'll be having a specific time period for that to give the refund, and you'll be having some prohibited actions, and you'll be having some alternate stores. You'll be having the rules about the product ratings and how to market your product, and you'll be having the license grants. and you will be having brand features and publicity, product removals. These sort of rules will be defined here in the agreement, and you can go through all these rules and policies before starting your development process. It will be always good to go through all these things before your development process begins, because you can design the application according to the rules defined here. So once you accept this, the next step is you have to go to the payment of the registration fee. When you click on this button here, you will get a pop-up asking for the developer registration fee. It will be $25, around 1500 rupees to 1600 Indian currency, and this is one license. So you can give your details here and you can continue after the payment. So once you complete this purchase, this ends up the process here, and the another account which is already having that license, once you log in directly, you will be going to the Google Play developer console. The straightaway dashboard will display some details about the applications, what you have already published or placed in your publisher account. It will display the list, and for every application you will be getting the name, price, whether it is a free application or paid application, how many number of active installations and total installations, total number of ratings and average ratings, how many times your application got crashed and how many times it is displaying application not responding, when was the last update given, and what is the status of the application. So this will be the list here on the dashboard. At a glance you can see the number of applications what you have placed on your publisher account, and once you open a particular application, you can see the details of the application, and you have to upload your APK file, and the APK file should be a signed APK file. Signing is the process of making yourself authenticated for the application, and Play Store will not allow unsigned APK files. You have to upload signed APK files. You'll be having a process for that, and you have to prepare the store listing page. For that you'll be giving some product details. So your application's name on the Google Play, that is your title, and it can be up to 30 characters, and then short description up to 80 characters. It will be the first text that will be appearing on the Google store listing page once it is opened, and once the user expands that, you'll be getting the full description, which can be up to 4000 characters. So the user will be understanding what is the application about and what are the features in the application. If it is an update of the application, what is the new content you have added? All these service level descriptions you can see here in the product details. And the next panel will ask you for the graphic assets. So you have to upload the high resolution icon, the icon that will be displayed on the Google store listing page straight away when you open the page. And the second one, you have to upload some screenshots. You can add up to 8 screenshots per device type. You'll be having 4 different categories: smartphones, tablet, Android TV and Android Wear devices. You can upload up to 8 screenshots per device. You can go up to 32 screenshots total, but a minimum of 2 screenshots are to be uploaded overall. That means you can upload one for tablet, one for smartphone, or you can upload another for Android TV. Minimum 2 screenshots are required, and you can go up to a maximum of 32 screenshots. And you'll be having the feature graphic. So this feature graphic will be a powerful one. It is required to be featured anywhere within the Google Play Store. So this icon will be displayed to the users whenever the position of the application goes up on the Play Store. And then you'll be having a banner asset. So if you are publishing your application which is Android TV enabled, this banner asset is required. If you are targeting a smartphone or tablet PC, you don't require this banner asset, but for Android TVs this banner asset is required. And then you'll be having promotional graphic. So this promotional graphic will be displayed when you are updating your application on the Google Play Store. So this will be used for promoting your application, and then you can upload a promotional video itself. When you are browsing some applications, you can see an image which is the feature graphic, or you can see a promotional video. So probably it will be a YouTube link. You can provide the link over there. Automatically the video will be displayed. These are the graphic assets what you should provide, and then you'll be having languages and translations. So when you target n number of countries, you need to upload the application with the support for all the languages what you are targeting. So you can do the translations locally in your application, or you can use the Google translation service. So it is a proprietary service, so you have to pay some amount and you have to make use of that app translation service. That is localization. And you can also provide the categorization details, what is your application type and what is the category of your application. So these are the different categories you are having. You have to select one category under which your application will be displayed. This first one will be the application type, the second one is games, and these are the different categories under these application types. And you have to provide your contact details, like your phone number, next your email if you are having a website. But the mandatory one is your email, which will be displayed to the users, and users can directly contact you through this email. And then you will be having privacy policy. So always adding a policy for your application, defining what you are doing in the application, what others cannot do, what others cannot copy from your application. So all the sensory information what you are going to provide, everything belongs to you as an application developer, and you have to define the policies in this privacy policy document. Normally on the websites you will be having this privacy policy link. You can directly provide that link there, and it's not mandatory. You can provide that link or you can leave it blank. And you have this app store optimization. So you have billions of applications available on the Play Store. Your target is to push your application onto the top pages. Normally when you are having websites kind of thing, it is called as search engine optimization, SEO. Android we call it as app store optimization. So you'll be having some techniques, some of the components you need to concentrate if you want to optimize your application and bring your application onto the top pages when the users are searching for the applications. And this signed application should be uploaded, and you have to prepare this store listing page. These are the product details. Then you have graphic assets. Then you have the categorization details and the contact details. And at the last, you can upload the privacy policy, or you can provide a link here. And the most important part is rating for the content of your application. You will be getting a questionnaire. You have to answer the questionnaire depending on your application category. And you will be having different agencies that will be giving the rating for your content. The primary agency is IARC, International Age Rating Coalition. This will be the primary agency, and these are all its associated bodies. Once you complete that questionnaire, a rating will be given. You can preview the rating, and once you are satisfied with that, you can apply the rating for your application. That rating will be displayed on the Google store listing page when you open the application on from the Play Store. And this is an important one that is introduced in the recent days, and this content rating should be provided for every new application what you are uploading, or for every update of the application, or even if your application is already active on the Play Store, you have to provide this content rating. So answer the questionnaire and generate the rating for your application. And pricing and distribution. So you can upload some free applications, or you can upload some paid applications. For these paid applications, you'll be having a price per application. You have to register your merchant account using the Google Wallet service. Google will be having an internal payment processor through which all these payments will be made, and you'll be having a transaction fee. When you are placing your application on the Play Store, Google will collect a transaction fee of 30%, and 70% will come to your account. So you require two things here. One thing is your bank account where money will be credited. Other one is your credit card. When people are asking for refund, then the money will be deducted from your credit card, and money will be credited into your bank account when the purchases are made. So the pricing and distribution. So distribution, you have to target n number of countries, and you'll be having content guidelines and US export laws. So all these guidelines we have to read carefully before placing your application on the Play Store. And the most important thing what this console will give you is the statistics about your application. So let us take, you have placed your application on the Play Store, people are downloading and using the application. You need to know how many number of people have downloaded your application so far, and how many people are uninstalling your application on a daily basis or monthly basis. You can get all these statistics here, daily installations, then current installations by the device, daily uninstallations, how many number of users are upgrading your application, total installations by the user, daily average rating, how many number of times your application got crashed, and how many times it is showing up application not responding. You can get the statistics for all these criteria, and it can be a weekly basis, monthly, year, or you can go for a lifetime. That means from the day when you have uploaded your application till date, you can see the complete statistics, and graphical reports will be given. So rather than seeing some numbers, when you are seeing the graphical reports, it will be easier to understand the ups and downs. This fragmentation will be based on Android version, because when you have multiple devices, one person may be using a 4.0 Android version, another one can be using a 7.0 version. So Android version based fragmentation will be there, devices, then you have tablets, countries in which you are distributing your application, languages, your application version. When you provide an update, all the users need not install your update. Some people will be still on the older version, even though an update is available on the Play Store. So based on this application version also, you can see the statistics, and you can see the installations on this particular date, and you can see the top 10 countries. This application is an education related application. You are seeing the statistics here for the top 10 countries in education. Play Store will give you some optimization tips. So it will ask you to promote your application with Google AdWords. You can create some campaign. You can promote your application. When the users are searching for your application, it will be displayed on the top page with an ad banner. And it is asking to design your application for tablets. This is an application which is designed for smartphones, for portrait orientation. If you design your application for tablets, you can reach more number of users on a wide variety of devices. So specifically when you design it for tablets, this particular label will be displayed, designed for tablets, listed in the Play Store. And you can follow all these optimization tips one by one, you can apply them, and once you finish them, that will be kept under this finish tab. And the important one is crashes and application not responding. So this will give you the complete statistics. So last 24 hours, how many number of times your application got crashed, on what versions your application is getting crashed. Suppose if my target is 4.0 to 7.1, it may crash on a device where the Android version is 5.0. So directly it will display the report here, and based on the application version itself. So you can create some filters, and you can always see this crashes and ANRs, and you can read these reviews given by the users and ratings given by the users. So you have to see to it that all these things are going good on your application once you place the application on the Play Store. So you will be having pre-optimization, pre-release optimization, and post-release optimization. All these things will be under post-release optimization. After placing the application on the Play Store, how best you are observing what is happening with your application, with the users who has downloaded your application. So this complete statistics will be provided by this Google Play Developer Console. So this will come with your Google Publisher account. Thank you for watching this, and in the next session we'll be looking at a different topic with respect to Android. Thank you.